your name on it. I think you'd take this. Did she take this as a door prize tonight? Yeah. Yeah, okay. Right, we'll have to get whoever a new one. So, I saw one of your trucks at my next door neighbor's. Was that Sunday? Saturday? Sunday?
If you're looking at your house to the right.
Yeah. No, actually, as I'm looking... He forgot.
Yes. Did he forget? Yes, he completely forgot. And I just wrote that. You need to be sworn in. You want to slide over here.
Can we start with Adam? You sure? All right. Here we go. I'd like to call this meeting to order of the Octorara Area School District Board of School Directors Reorganization Meeting, December 2nd, 2019. Please rise for a moment of silence and pledge allegiance to the flag. Madam Secretary, roll call. All right. At this time, I would like to, I need a motion to open nominations for a temporary president. All right. Matt Hurley.
Second.
And Jerry Zimmerman. All right. Nominations for a temporary president. Somebody needs a second, right? Okay, so Charlie and Matt. Any additional nominations for temporary president at this time? All right, hearing none, I need a motion to close nominations for temporary president.
So moved.
Jerry Zimmerman. Matt Hurley. All right, so where do I go from here?
All those in favor say aye.
All right, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? All right, motion carries. At this time.
I should have, moonwalked over here just to sit right off
for Bill. All right, at this time,
yeah.
I turn the meeting over to our temporary president, Mr. Gano.
At this time, I'd like to read the list of holdover directors into the minutes. Samuel Gano, Region 2, term expires in 2021. Jerry Zimmerman, Region 2, term expires in 2021. Charles Conacher, Jr., Region 3, term expires in 2021. And the R. Matthew Hurley, which we don't know what the R stands for, Region 3.
Rockstar.
Term expires in 2021. We have the list of newly elected board members. We have William Kloss from Region 1. Term will expire in 2023. Anthony Flagatori, Region 1. Term will expire in 2023. Brian Norris, Region 1. Term will expire in 2023. Lisa Bowman, Region 2. term will expire in 2023. Brian Fox, Region 3, term will expire in 2023. The regions are as follows. Region 1 is at Glenboro, the borough of Christiana, Lancaster County, Parksburg North, West Salisbury Township. Region 2 is Salisbury Township in Lancaster County, West Fallowfield Township. Region 3 is Highland Township, Londonderry Township, and Parksburg South. Judge Gale, will you administer the oath to the newly elected officers?
Don't call us last.
Well, hopefully, I'll ask you to stick around.
Good evening, everyone.
Judge, if you could turn on that mic right there, that would be awesome. Okay. We might be able to hear you a little bit better.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Okay. Is that better?
Yes, it is.
I, Anthony Falvatore.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support.
That I will support.
Obey.
And defend.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of this Commonwealth.
And the Constitution of this Commonwealth.
And that I will discharge the duties.
And I will discharge the duties.
Of my office.
Of my office.
With fidelity.
With fidelity.
Okay, I'm going to ask you to sign these votes, and I'll give you one more. You work well as a board. You're good, good people.
I'm late and Sam's in a presidency. It's a bad trick. It's a nightmare.
Come on forward.
Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of this Commonwealth.
Could all the new board members go back over there with Jill for a picture, please? Judge Gill, we really appreciate you coming out tonight. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
My pleasure. I hope you all have a wonderful holiday season.
As to you and your family. Actually, Jill, why don't you get Judge Gill on that as well? At this time, I'd like to open up nominations for the president's position. Actually, at the beginning, I'd like to open up a motion to open the nominations, please. Thank you. Motion made and seconded to open the nominations. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
At this time, I'd like to take motions for president.
I nominate
Brian Fox has one nomination. Are there any others? Seeing none, is there a motion to close nominations? Second. Nomination, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Nominations being closed with only one name. By default, Brian Fox is now the president. Please assume this position.
I'd like to nominate Lisa Bowman.
Other nominations? Hearing none, motion to close.
I make a motion to close the nomination.
Mr. President, I do have one rule of order. Mr. Norris is the ranking non-officer at this time. He gets the option to move his seat wherever he wants. Is that the seat you'd like? Then you have one more seat you can bump out.
By default.
Eye contact across the room.
Can I take a minute? I'd like to say something if I could real quick. As you all know, I'm the IU rep, and one of the fortunate things, I get to hear some chatter among some other board members, and I think we have a unique situation here amongst ourselves. We treat each other with respect and dignity. We don't always agree. And I think a lot of that starts at the top. And I think it's appropriate to acknowledge the guide, the leadership that Lisa has given this board. I don't even remember how many years it's been. You know, she's led this board with, she's led this board with class and distinction, and has provided just tremendous leadership for us all. So Brian, you have, though she has like really small, always stylish shoes, you have very large shoes to fill. And I'm certain you'll be successful at it.
Thank you. Thanks.
I think it's fair to say that Lisa, this was Lisa's decision not to, not seek election.
Well, then I get to say one thing and then I don't have to ever speak again, I think so. But I do want to say that I know I support Brian Fox as president and the whole board supports you. So you do have the support and confidence, and we thank you for actually saying yes to doing this. And to Brian, who has been vice president for, I would say, 8 or 9 years, and I know I am so grateful that you sat beside me. I'm so thankful and grateful for your support. And I said it last week or last month, there's no one that loves this district, loves the students of this district and this Octorara community more than you. And we are very fortunate that we've got another 4 years. So thank you very much, because that's no one likes it as much as you do. So thank you, and I'm
done. Okay, then I'll move to make the following appointments. A, representative to the Lancaster County Tax Collection Bureau for the calendar year 2020 will be Jeff Curtis. Alternative representative to the Lancaster County Tax Collection Bureau for the calendar year 2020 will be Matt Furlong. Representative to the Chester County Tax Collection Bureau for the calendar year 2020, Jeff Curtis. Alternative representative to the Chester County Tax Collection Bureau for the calendar year 2020, Matt Furlong. Legislative Committee representative for the calendar year 2020, Lisa Bowman. IUCAT Board representative, Brian Norris, which term expires in 2020. PSBA representative for the calendar year 2020, Lisa Bowman. Personnel Committee, Sam Gano, Chair, Brian Norris, and Anthony Falgitor. Facilities Committee, Brian Norris, Chair, Bill Kloss, Charlie Conacher, and Jerry Zimmerman. Policy Committee, Lisa Bowman, Chair, myself, Brian Fox, and Matt Hurley. Finance Committee, Sam Gano, Chair, Brian Norris, and Bill Kloss. Representative to the Chester County School Authority with the term expiring 2021, Brian Norris. And Education Committee Chair, myself, Brian Fox, Brian Norris, and Anthony Falgitor. I'd like to thank everybody for taking those appointments for the next set of appointment terms. Resolution regarding meeting times is the next reading item. That in conformance with Act 175, PA Legislature, the Octorara Area Board of School Directors will meet in regular session in the junior senior high school on the third Monday of each month at 7 p.m. And that the board work sessions open to the public will normally be held the second Monday of each month at 7 p.m. in the junior senior high school. Note, there is no work session scheduled for July. Executive sessions will be scheduled before and or following each regular and work session meeting, and the annual reorganization meeting will be held on December 7th, 2020 at 7 p.m., followed by the December work session. The December 2020 regular monthly public board meeting will be held on December 14th, 2020 at 7 p.m. I'd like a motion to adjourn the...
A motion for the resolution.
Oh, that's a resolution. I need a motion for this resolution that I just read, please.
So moved.
And a second?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Okay, resolution passes. Thank you. Need a motion to adjourn the reorganization meeting.
So moved.
Second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Okay, meeting adjourned. Better make sure this is on tight. The top doesn't come off.
Doug.
Safety glasses.
Yeah.
I'll bring them next.
Okay.
I'll borrow some from the shop.
I'd like to call the regular work session to order for the December 2nd meeting of the Octorara Area School District. First item on our agenda are presentations. Do we have presentations?
We do not this evening.
No presentations. Visitor comments for agenda items only. No. Any information items? Okay. Then I'd like to present the agenda items for the December 9th, 2019 regular monthly public meeting next week. A, that the Octorara Board of School Directors approve the annual fiscal audit report of the district for the year ending June 30th, 2019 as prepared by the auditing firm of Herbine & Company. B, that the Octorara Board of School Directors approve the opt-out resolution for the 2020-2021 budget process. C, that the Octorara Board of School Directors approve a half-year sabbatical leave for the second semester of the 2019-2020 school year for Ms. Rachel Minich. Ms. Minich is an art CTE design and illustration teacher at the Octorara Junior Senior High School. D, that the Octorara Board of School Directors approve the rate schedule for Kegel Kalen Almi and Lord, LLP, for January 1st, 2020 through December 31st, 2020. E, that the Octorara Board of School Directors approve the issuance of the following diplomas, Student A, dated October 31st, 2019, and Student B, dated December 20th, 2019. F, that the Octorara Board of School Directors approve the following policies, first reading, 100 Comprehensive Planning, 101 Mission Statement, Vision Statement, Shared Values, 102 Academic Standards, 103 Non-Discrimination and Discriminatory Harassment for the School and Classroom Practices, 103.1 Non-Discrimination for Qualified Students with Disabilities, 104 Non-Discrimination Discriminatory Harassment for Employment Practices, 105 Curriculum, 105.1 Review of Instructional Materials by Parents, Guardians, and Students, 105.2 Exemption from Instruction, 106, Guides for Planned Instruction. 107, Adoption of Planned Instruction. 108, Adoption of Textbooks. 109, Resource Materials. 110, Instructional Materials, Instructional Supplies. And 111, Lesson Plans. Item G, under resignation approvals, that the Octorara Board of School Directors accept the resignation of Ms. Bonita DeForest as a lunchroom playground supervisor at the Octorara Intermediate School effective November 15th, 2019. Item H, under hiring approvals, that the Octorara Board of School Directors approve Mr. Colin Kolb as a computer systems technology teacher at the Octorara Junior Senior High School effective January 2nd, 2020, pending completion of employee-related documents required by law and the district. Mr. Kolb's salary will be $56,159 prorated, which is step 12 to max of the bachelor's scale.
I have a
yep.
Why is this hard to mean that he'll be here? Is that in regards to the sabbatical or is that
somehow? If you had recalled last year, we had talked about hiring this position mid-year because computer systems technology. Right. That's okay. If you recall, computer systems technology is a new career and technical education program that we will actually offer to students and open next year, and we need a half a year in order for the individual to come in and build the occupational advisory committee, get the lab set up, work through all the curriculum requirements and everything else, all the other good planning things that need to go into opening up a career in technical education program from scratch.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Any other comments, questions? Then we'll move on to item I, that the Octorara Board of School Directors approve the following substitute teachers for the 2019-2020 school year, Marcy Yeich, a nurse. And next agenda item, number four, committee reports. I'll start with Ed Committee, and then we also have Policy and Facilities Committee. The Education Committee met on Monday, November 25th.
Sorry.
Yeah.
You
what did I skip?
Five, six, seven, eight.
I moved to committee reports because committee reports weren't included on the agenda. Yeah. No, does it?
That one does.
No, it doesn't. You don't have committee reports.
Yeah, you missed the committee.
You missed committee reports.
Yeah, on four, so, yeah.
Oh, it's your fault.
Yeah. No, no, no.
Okay, I
you, okay.
Let's start between you two.
Yeah. Yeah. It's the only time I'll be right. Yeah. For the rest of the 4 years, no, the rest of the 4 years it won't be.
Kept that in your pocket.
Or actually, this is just a 1 year term.
I was gonna say.
The education committee. So, do you want to do it in this sequence, or do you want to do it after the?
Yeah, we'll do it. You're at the right time. You're good.
Okay. So, education committee meeting met on Monday, November 25th. We had updates on the professional learning communities update. We discussed start and end times as a area that we would like to study, given the research and what some of the other districts and what some other states are doing across the country. We got an update on the comprehensive plan with more coming, as that committee will be reconvening and will work on the comprehensive plan. We got a quick update on the math coach and the school improvement plan. And then we had a discussion about the Air Force Junior ROTC partnership potential with Coatesville. So those were our discussion items. Comments or questions? Okay, policy committee.
All right, the policy committee met this evening, and first thing to let everyone know, in January, our athletic director will be coming to our policy meeting, and we'll be discussing policy 707 and 710, which have to do with our athletic facilities and rentals, et cetera. And then we had a first reading of the policies that Brian read through. There's 15 different policies. Again, we're going through all our policies right now, so there was a lot. There were little tweaks that we've made on some of them in the first reading. So that was it.
Thank you. Questions, comments? Facility committee?
Yes, we met earlier this evening. We learned the elementary school roof that was damaged a little while ago in the windstorm was completed. The copier that we that was damaged, well, there'll be the lease for that was signed. Again, this is all covered through insurance, and we'll be assessing when the appropriate time to redo the carpeting in the office that was damaged as a result of some rain with the damaged roof. The asbestos abatement in the high school vault will be done December 30th at the cost of $2,500. It's expected to take a day or two, and obviously when the kids are not in session. We have a candidate that Jeff will probably be bringing for our consideration for the reposting of the evening custodial position. They have someone in mind, they'd like to offer the job, and we gave them the okay to go ahead and pursue that. We'll learn more about that next time. And then we also discussed the recarpeting of room 102 just down the hall here. That'll get done probably the same time that the carpet gets done for the elementary school. And that was it. Any questions for anyone?
Questions, comments? Okay, thanks. Moving on, we have other items or concerns? None. Any other visitor comments, General? No. Administrator comments or announcements?
I don't know if any of you have noticed, if you go back to the ag area, there are no longer any turkeys there.
Coincidence? I think not.
Look, I'm funny. The students, actually, you know, they raised the turkeys from being very young, and they grew big, and they went through the whole process of what they do to turkeys before Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
And then it went through the process of my oven, so I can attest that they were very good, but it was a very nice process for the students and, you know, what they did. So, there you go.
Yes. Oh, well, pardon. Yeah.
You
should have pardoned.
That's a great idea. Please be so pardoned.
Thank
Good evening. This Thursday night is December 5th, I believe, and it is one of our biggest nights, I would say, of the year. It's our holiday literacy night, so it's a little bit different this year. We're going to go right into centers. Santa will be there. We expect a huge crowd, so that's exciting. And then next Wednesday night is our second grade art and music show. Both nights start at 6:30. So, thank you.
Six special education teachers and two reading specialists, all in grades K to 4, are taking part in a three-year training called Letters, Language Essentials for Teachers of Reading and Spelling. They're about four sessions a year. This training drills down to reading fundamentals when students struggle with typical traditional methods. PDE fully recommends this training and is considering actually making it an essential training for school entities. It takes place over 3 years because teachers get the training, then they're allowed to practice with students, implement, and then reflect on how students have done and how to adjust their instruction. And we're about halfway through the first year now.
Very good. Thanks.
Alrighty. So I just wanted to provide the board and our community with a communications and community engagement plan update. And I just want to start with thanking the good folks of Parksburg for allowing us to attend their town hall a couple days before the Thanksgiving break. Small and appreciative group, right? What do you say, about 10 to 12, 10 to 15 folks there. We've been invited back in the spring, so that's a positive, right? About 90 minutes in length, few questions, very few, and certainly nothing that we couldn't address there as a team. There were a variety of things that we did. I mean, we certainly went with an agenda full of stuff, and you know, anytime you can go with folks who work in your school and kids who attend your schools, I mean, that's always going to be a good night out for all. But from a district standpoint, we talked about the impending enrollment study. The folks in Parksburg were very appreciative of that, that the board had the foresight to take a look at that to see exactly what is going on. In fact, they were very surprised when I shared some of the class size, some of the cohort size. They were not aware of that. They are grateful for the pilot of the 3-hour delay this year. They're very appreciative to see how that goes. And they were also invited to serve on our comprehensive planning committee. So Catherine was there to share a Home of the Braves character education program update. That went over real well. Our homeland security kids and staff were there along with our director of career and technical education to talk about all things CTE and just share that homeland security spotlight. Kids were a big hit. So like I said, anytime folks in our community get to hear from our kids or talk to our kids, that's a good thing. And of course, Beth Patika and our preschool and kindergarten outreach, that was a big hit as well. So our goal was to visit every municipality this year. We want to get into every municipality. And we understand, you know, they're not going to give us the hour and a half that Parksburg gave us, but, you know, anything that we can do to take the show on the road to them is a good thing. one of the things as I reflect on the implementation of our communication and community engagement plan this year, we have the most success. It appears that we have the most success when we invite the community into us for specific events. Okay, now that doesn't mean that we should discount our sporting events or you know, anything else that we do, but when we arrange a day like Grandparents' Day for people to come in, and I know in my superintendent spotlight last week I talked about this, just what a compelling day that was to have our community engaged in those third and fourth grade classrooms. And I meant what I said in that spotlight. I could just hear the conversation, you mm-hmm. know, that, you know, around that Thanksgiving, you know, folks talking about what they got to experience in that brief hour and a half that they were in our school. So really want to thank the staff and everybody who had just had the foresight to say, you know, what if we create a day specifically for them, you know, to come in. So it appears when we think of things outside of the normal things that we do, like the concerts and the sporting events, that seems to be getting a lot of traction. So that's something that we should, you know, really spend our time on. The website is a big project for us right now, and we continue to work with Chad from M Street on our new site. At the Finance Committee meeting next week, we're going to have an update on this. Many of our action steps in our current communication and communication plan are directly related to that website. And those are things that we've talked about before in the plan, like the app, one searchable calendar for everyone to use, and a fast facts page. But, you know, all in all, I continue to hear a lot of positives from the community. This is very much a social media kind of crowd. So, you know, Facebook, I'm just amazed that when Jill and I post things up there to see what kind of traction that gets, and the number of shares that it gets, you know, as well. I really appreciate the weekly communication from our schools. I hear a lot of parents and community members tell me how much they appreciate the fact that the principals of those schools are coming up with a way to push out some type of weekly communication to mom and dad. Our athletic communication is something that I also hear a lot of positives about as well, that the communication between just the athletic director to the coaching staff to the parents, that, you know, that everybody seems to be on the same page there. The preschool and the kindergarten outreach piece, you know, as well. So, you know, we continue to address every aspect of that plan. Some of the projects in that plan are a little larger and more complicated than we anticipated. For example, the website is consuming more of our time, you know, as we work with Chad. But in the end, I think we're actually going to have a better process, right, and a better website for our parents, our families, and our community to go to get the information that they need when they need it.
Okay. Did you have overlap between the Parksburg Point attendance and the town hall, the people? Did you happen to?
I didn't notice. So Lisa and Krista were there, and Catherine were there. Did you notice anybody? I think it was a new crowd.
Yeah. Okay, well, that's good. I mean, that's good, because you get more.
Yeah.
You're getting more mm-hmm. people.
Yep.
Thank you for that. Thank
yep,
you.
Absolutely.
Moving on to board comments. Any comments from across the Bill?
I guess I don't really have a comment, but Lisa, I think there was a pretty big fire down at the Weiss a couple weeks ago, and I don't know, I'm not putting you on the spot, but I'm pretty sure we had a pretty strong presence from a lot of our students. I don't know if you, it's just something to be said about, you know, our program and what it does to the community and mm-hmm. students who are currently in the program and graduating the program, and, you know, they're out there 1 a.m. with a 3-alarm fire, and seeing how skilled they are to, you know, take down a fire to that extent was, I mean, it makes me feel proud for the students. I want to say I feel good about the fire, but it definitely just hearing about how well those students did and the training that we provided for them makes me feel pretty good. So just wanted to throw that out there. Good job by you and the program and the students. Thank you.
Yep, nicely done. Other comments? I just have one, just a reminder that December 8th, our PSBA training IDs go live. And so we can start taking the courses. And Dr. Orner sent a note to us. There's a face-to-face training, Radnor and somewhere else, I think. So if you wanted to go face-to-face, you could go face-to-face.
Hey, I volunteer to be the outlier and see what happens if you don't do it.
Yeah. I thought about that. I thought about that little bit of civil disobedience. Yeah, I've thought about that myself.
I don't know how confident I feel about your first meeting you're giving us homework to do.
Yeah.
At least wait a little bit.
Right. It's not me, it's the state legislature, which is really most of what we have to deal with. So it's,
Exactly.
I'd like to make a comment that maybe Bill could put that next year's organization meeting in his calendar now.
That's okay, we'll send him a text. We'll send him a text. Anything else on board, board comments? Okay. Thanks, then I'll announce the following meetings. The Executive Committee met after the Ed Committee on Monday, November 25th, and we will have another Executive Committee for Personnel after tonight's work session. Policy Committee meeting met today, Monday, December 2nd at 5:30 in the District Office Conference Room. Facility Committee meeting was also held today, Monday, December 2nd at 6:30 in the District Conference Room. Reorganization meeting was today, 7 o'clock in the Junior High Multipurpose Room. Our next regularly scheduled work session was today, Monday, December 2nd, 2019, immediately following our reorganization meeting. Finance Committee meeting meets next week, Monday, December 9th at 6 o'clock in the District Office Conference Room. Our next regularly scheduled board meeting, Monday, December 9th, 2019, 7 o'clock in the Junior High School Multipurpose Room. With that, I'd like a motion for adjournment. And a second? Properly moved and seconded. All those in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Okay, meeting adjourned. Thank you.
Good stuff.
Good stuff.